My coverage of CES 2025 is brought to you by Gigabyte, Lexar, MSI, and Thermaltake.
Hey guys, I made my way over to the CES show floor today where it is a madhouse, especially here at LG. They have a new replacement for their big wall of curved monitors. Instead, they have an AI display. It's not artificial intelligence though, it's affectionate intelligence, which I don't know, I'm burnt out on AI, but that's just kind of cute. The wall has these LCD panels that pop out and they're showing an AI demo, and it's pretty cool looking. I don't know if it's more impressive than the wall of LEDs that they've had in the past, but I'm getting distracted. I'm actually here to check out the LG Ultragear new monitors. They have three of them. I'm gonna show you all three right now. Let's start out right here with the one that has the biggest crowd around it, which is the world's first 5K2K bendable gaming monitor. Now we've seen bendable gaming monitors before. You guys might be familiar with the Corsair Xenion Flex. That used an LG panel. LG actually made a monitor with that same panel that wasn't flexible, but LG has stepped up with this most recent one, 5K2K, so it's 5120 by 2160 resolution. It is a 45-inch OLED display with 0.03 gray to gray response time, and it is a dual mode display. It can switch between 165Hz at WUHD resolution or 330Hz if you drop that down to 1080 vertical. But of course, the big feature, the most visually appealing feature, is the fact that this thing curves. And it can actually curve in a few ways. For the show, they have these buttons set up so you can just push a button and it will curve itself. But you will be able to do that via physical buttons on the monitor. I'm told there are hand gestures you can also do to make it curve itself. Or you can have it sync up with the LG app on your phone, and you can use your phone to bend your monitor. If there's one complaint about the Corsair Xenion Flex, it's that you had to manually bend it, and it almost felt like you were breaking it sometimes. So it's really cool to see a nice fluid bending motion that's motorized, that you don't have to use your own muscles to crank one way or the other. And it goes from between flats to 800R curve. As you can see, it's won CES Innovation Awards, and this is a very popular display here at LG. Lots of people have been checking it out and just pressing these buttons, which is a lot of, I'm gonna make it go curved again. Curved. You can also stop it in between. So anywhere between flat and 800R curve, you can set up this monitor. My big question was how much this is gonna cost. We don't know. We don't have a launch date for it quite yet. I ballparked like maybe $2,500. That's kind of my estimate, but that's really just a guess at this point. Over here we have that same exact panel, so same specs in terms of the resolution, 5120 by 2160, as well as the dual mode features. Basically same panel in a fixed curve display, and this one actually is curved a little bit more than the bendable one. This one goes up to 900R curvature, but it is fixed, so you can't bend it back. So don't try, because you'll break your monitor if you do that. I like the housing work that they've done on this as well. One of the updates LG has done recently for their displays is the stand. It's an L-shaped stand instead of the V that was happening before, which took up a lot more space on the desk. They say this is just as stable while giving you a little bit more room on your desk for activities, I suppose. They have some racing sims set up for these displays and people are having a good time with it. The housing for the panel does have some RGB on the back, and of course it's got some height and tilt adjustments. Beyond that, pivot and swivel is not quite as doable with a display this size. So big old 45-inch monitors and a couple different varieties over there, but if that's too rich for your blood. Then over here we have something a bit more modest in the 39GX OSA. So this one is a 39-inch diagonal display, 3440 by 1440, which is a very commonly supported resolution for PC gaming and otherwise. This one does have a fixed 800R curvature, but the panel still has really impressive specs. 240Hz refresh rate, 0.03 millisecond gray to gray response time, 98.5% DCI P3 color gamut. I'm told these are prototype samples that they have for display at the show. I asked again for the pricing for this one. We're looking to ballpark around 1600-ish or so. That's still a loose figure that could change before these come to market. We're looking at probably a Q1 timeframe release, possibly pushing to Q2. So nice crossover specs between gaming and also getting some production done. Oh, and did I mention 800R curvature and 240Hz refresh rate? That's really nice for gaming. All right, guys, so that's the 39GX. Just a few monitors to share with you guys here at the LG Ultragear area. They have a lot more going on, AI and like home goods and stuff like that, but I'll spare you all that. Go to a different YouTube channel for coverage of that stuff. It's also very pink. It's very pink over here. I don't know why just the Ultragear area is all pink. I feel like the rest of the LG suite is less pink. But wow, that lighting is getting... But okay, I'll stop spinning in circles. That's all for this video. I want to say a huge thank you to my sponsors for CES 2025, Thermaltake, MSI, Gigabyte, and Lexar. I do have More content still, so if you're enjoying it, hit the thumbs up button. Check out the playlist if you missed anything. We'll see you all in the next video.